hope you are all doing well, and I hope everything is fine with you. I also hope that you're having a peaceful pre-finals week kind of period. Okay, so what I'm going to do in this video is basically go over how to study for a physics exam. Okay, so I know that the final is like in 4 days from now, so I thought I might as well do such a video to help you out study or prepare for the final exam. Okay, so college, I mean physics in college is basically two things, concepts and doing them up. Like, it's basically doing well in any exam in college, physics exam. It's centered around understanding concepts and then knowing your math, the physics concept. However, high scores are heavily related to doing the math. So if you want to score a high score on an exam, on a physics exam, and you don't have enough time to look deeply into the concepts, then this looks on this scale, doing the math, or let's call it problem solving. Okay, so problem solving is very important, very important, and it's developed. You can develop it using a lot of exercises, solving old exams and solving books problem. Okay, so. Okay, before we go, like the first thing you want to do in order to prepare for the physics exam is build the concepts. Like, you cannot go here without knowing the concepts. Okay, so your first thing about that concept is the slides. So all professors like upload the slides in Blackboard, so and I also downloaded all the slides of Professor Kunwar. And I will be attaching it to the video, so you'll be finding it in the description. And I hope you guys don't have any problem with the access, so do let me know if you don't have access to it. Okay, so the chapters that the final is going to cover is basically from 16 to 30. And you will find all the slides, Professor's memoir slides, for all these chapters down in the description. Okay, so your slides is basically the very first thing that you want to do in study. So if you find yourself having or struggling with some ideas or some concepts, then go to the textbook. The textbook is very detailed, and it could help you out like in clearing things that were not clear in that slide. I also recommend Khan Academy, or some other any other video on YouTube, or any other video you can find on the internet. But Khan Academy was specifically helpful to me. Okay, so once you're done, once you think you have a good grasp of what's going on in the chapter you're studying, then you move on to the doing the math or the problem solving skill, which is the most important skill that you want to learn before going into a physics exam. Okay, so as I just mentioned, solve as many questions as you can from all the exams from the book, and then until you think that you have a very good understanding of how the problems in a given chapter can be solved. Okay, let's go into an example. Like, for example, if you have a capacitor. Another capacitor and battery. So understanding the idea of parallel, like these two capacitors are connected in parallel with the battery. So you know that you're going to add this using C1, C2, C2, C2. So understanding the idea of a parallel connection helps you do the math that needs to. And if these two capacitors were in series, you would know that the way to add them is like this. So understanding the concept is very important before you go into the math. And doing the math or problem solving is also very important. It's not enough to only understand the concept. Okay, so as far as the final example go, 16 questions will be asked on the last four chapters. And the rest, 40 questions will be asked in everything that we took before these four chapters. So you need to really focus on the last four chapters. And so questions from the last four chapters are going to be more challenging than other questions. So because you guys have not practiced the old materials for a long time, so it does not make sense for them to give you hard questions on these old materials. And therefore, the most challenging question will be from the last four chapters. Okay, guys, so one thing that I want to emphasize is that if you dedicate enough time to understand the concept and really build a good understanding of the concept, and then dedicate enough time to do the math, then physics is easy. It will not be hard to score high score on the final or any physics exam for that matter. So the key thing to scoring high is time management. You have to manage your time in college, and then you have to dedicate enough time to understand the concept and practice the problem solving skills. So that concludes our video, and I wish you guys good luck in the final, and I'll see you.